And welcome back. This is the RPG Chick. Whoa, we always start out like this. Skipping frames. Oh crap. We kind of got blur going on and everything. Unfortunately. It should stop in a few minutes. That's a random waypoint. So this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Andromeda Blind. We are back on the Hyperion as of last episode. The voice of Liara Tassoni can be heard in there, which is awesome. Wasn't expecting that. So yeah, kind of wondering who else is going to show up. No spoilers, please, guys. Okay, we came from here. Need to speak with Sam. I guess we'll just continue back where we were. Now, SAM node. I don't think this is my rig as far as the choppiness. It happens more in the beginning, like when I start playing, when the game is loaded, than any other time. Sometimes I do get some choppiness on the tram because objects are moving forward at an incredible rate of speed, and meanwhile, you know, my character and other characters walking around. That's an intensive graphical sequence there, but otherwise seems okay to me. If you guys see something else, let me know. So here's Sam.
Hello, Sarah. Welcome back to SAMnode. I've adjusted my connection to your implant. The headache you experienced before shouldn't reoccur.
Yeah, what was that about? You said we need to discuss something confidential?
You should know certain facts before you leave on your expedition. It seemed best we speak alone.
Well, aren't you like in my head? You can talk to me alone anytime. Why the secrecy?
I don't understand the need for secrecy.
Your father felt it was for the best.
What was he trying to hide?
My true capabilities. Alec overrode the implant safety protocols. It allows me unrestricted access to the Pathfinder's physiology.
And that's me now.
And only you. Duh. I can act as a force multiplier, dramatically enhancing your motor and neural skills when required.
Sweet.
Alec called them profiles. They provide unique tactical augmentation during combat.
Unlocked.
Your father preferred to keep this fact to himself.
Now this has been unlocked this entire time. This menu selection has been unavailable, so now it's unlocked. My father preferred to keep it to himself. It could scare people.
I can understand. People might get the wrong idea. Super soldiers.
Captain America.
Computer having control over a human.
Ultron.
Providing an enhancement to the human. It is a symbiotic relationship that benefits both.
Venom.
What do you get out of it?
Though I'm artificial in design, I am fully sentient.
Vision.
Far beyond what even the initiative understands.
I can keep going here.
I don't follow. You're an AI, so what's different?
I am a new form of AI, drawing directly from the human experience. Your implant is my window into the world.
But you're just a computer. wow. Yeah, I'm still the boss.
But the human's still in charge, right?
Of course. I was never intended to supplant the Pathfinder. Only to support and enhance your abilities.
We know Skynet.
Good to hear. So what's the plan?
We know Skynet.
I find myself in an unusual position. Though I had access to your father's experiences, there is a gap in my understanding.
How so?
He placed a block on portions of my memory array.
Why?
Perhaps so when you asked me what his plan was, I wouldn't know.
And Dad strikes again.
But not without recourse. The further you explore as a Pathfinder, the more blocks will be removed.
But of course.
Perhaps you should begin in your father's quarters.
I was there.
In the meantime, unless you have more questions, your new ship awaits.
Thanks.
We have to go back to his quarters now? Okay. So these are locked. I'm guessing Adept is unlocked. Okay, because apparently Adept is a further level of Biotic, which I took originally. What's that flashing? Every once in a while it flashes like that. See that? That's annoying. We didn't need lightning in the menu screen, thank you very much. See that? It's like part of the image from before, trying to come through. Freaky Bioware, freaky. Adepts are biotic specialists capable of disabling and killing enemies with powerful mass effect fields. Yes. This profile reconfigures Ryder's biotic implant, enabling her to defeat her opponents without firing a single shot. Nice. I kind of like, you know, want as less guns as possible. It's just where I'm coming from. Biotic jump and evades. Instead of a jump jet, use biotics to jump and evade. Cool. Biotic echoes. Biotic combos can set off additional explosions on every enemy they touch. Okay, so if I go select a profile. Yeah, we can only select this one, so consider yourself selected. I'm selecting again. What is this doing? Okay, well, I guess it's selected. Weird how you just turn that as whatever. Adept rank 2. Okay. What else? Journal. Codex we have to look at eventually. Weapons and stuff. Damage. More damage, less rate of fire, much smaller clip size. Less max ammo. Accuracy is a little bit better. I'm sticking with the charger. Deconstruct. So the M3 Predator 1 is a reliable semi-automatic pistol. Originally manufactured by Alanis Risk Control, the rapid-fire Predator is a deadly and inexpensive weapon. Although Milky Way militaries generally avoided using the Predator, the Andromeda initiative obtained and adjusted several hundred of them. And we can go back. View statistics. Oh, compare. Wait. Page down. Well, we can compare like thusly. Compare. Alright, cool. That's a cool at a glance like that. So I'm gonna keep the charger. Because you can carry a lot more. Well, I don't even have to switch back and forth. You can carry a lot more clips. You don't have to reload as often and all that stuff. I mean, the damage is a little better, but I don't know if it's that much. 19 and 38 makes how much difference? Does how much more damage every time you fire? I don't think it would be that much. So I take that. What if I... Oh, this is what I have. Okay, how do I... I can't just equip this here. It'd be cool if we can. Do I have to go to weapon wheel? No. Rider family secrets. Find a way to remove Sam's memory block. So I guess there'll be more to do in his quarters. That's map. So the other pistol, the charger, this sturdy submachine gun is standard issue inside the Andromeda Initiative security forces. The Initiative commissioned the automatic charger from Alanis Risk Control Services. The company heavily customized one of their existing weapons to meet Initiative needs. They gotta fix this flicker. It's really annoying. I do want to use the charger as soon as I can figure out how the hell to do that. Assault rifles. I do like the lore about the guns and such and the different companies. That's why I'm reading this. You know me. So the M8 Avenger 1. Meaning there will be more. A common and versatile assault rifle. The M8 Avenger's modular design and inexpensive components make it a favorite of military groups and mercenaries in the Milky Way. Many Avengers were acquired for Andromeda Initiative security forces. The sturdy rifle has a reputation for being reliable and easy to use. Now, am I using weight by having all this stuff? Because here we have melee. Krogan hammer, which I equipped without meaning to. Can I? Oh, I can. I can. Oh, cool. I like that. So it's a rare melee weapon. As opposed to the Omniblade 1. A brutal weapon, the incredible force of this mechanized hammer is enhanced by precision pistons and mass effect fields. Such hammers are commonly used by Elder Krogan warlords, though this particular model has been modified for especially strong humans or young Krogan. So that's 400 melee damage. The Omniblade 1 is 275 melee. This disposable silicon carbide weapon can be forged by an Omni-Tools fabricator. The transparent Omni-Blade is suspended in a mass effect field safely away from the user's skin, and warning lights illuminate the field so the searing blade only burns the intended enemy. Now, I can't see getting rid of the Omni-Blade because you use it for various things. At least that's the way it normally worked. So... Unless, no, I'm thinking of the Omni-Tool. I don't know. I'm going to hold on to it. Pistol mods. So I got a magazine. Increases magazine capacity. Plus 40%. And I got pistol scope. Optical scope to enhance stability while zoomed. Also increases accuracy while moving. So I can't apply this stuff here as far as I can tell. I guess we have to wait till we're in combat, and then we get to the weapon wheel and I can mess with stuff. Although that's stupid, I like to be, you know, not forewarned, but I like to be ready ahead of time. So that's nice, they have it split into different gun mods here. So I have a magazine capacity for the assault rifle, we got a scope, and AR stock 1. Now, some of this stuff is equipped, but it doesn't say if it is or not. I know I equipped some of it. Shotgun mods. Melee optimizer. Integrated VI improves synergy between melee weapon and firearm computer systems, allowing increased melee damage, so plus 10% melee damage. I hardly ever do melee, so I'm not going to mess with it. Plus, I'm not going to be using a shotgun, at least I don't think so. I might try it out once, I don't know, see how it is. Receiver? Receiver 1. Capacitor boosts kinetic coil generators, increasing shot penetration through solid objects. So plus 40% shotgun penetration damage, and plus 0.5 shotgun ammo penetration distance, which is, I don't know, a couple inches? Shotgun spare clip. Add sockets to increase thermal clip capacity, increasing number of spare shots, plus 50% shotgun spare ammo. And then sniper rifle mods, which I'm probably not going to be using sniper rifle. I don't know, I might eventually try it. So we got the scope for this, and the thermal clip, increasing spare shots. Alright. So armor here, we got the helmet. Help protect the wearer from hazardous environments and the dangers of combat. You can visually hide your helmet, but retain its gameplay benefits in the gameplay settings menu. Now, I'm pretty sure I did that. But yet, all through the first mission, she had a helmet on, which I didn't mind because it makes sense. I mean, then the helmet breaks, so it'd be stupid for her to be walking around the entire time without... This looks different. This looks like wider or something. I don't know. Wasn't there, like, more going on the side? So, be under gameplay. Just checking to make sure. Off in conversations. Ah! They changed this. Oh, did it? No. It started like this. I changed it to this. Off in conversations. Yeah, have it on with gameplay. Although, I don't know. I might change it because I there was a little friendly fire because I couldn't tell who was who. If I see like a human head with like hair and stuff, then I'll be like, yeah, it's not a cat. So, and I wasn't done there. So, armor, helmet. So the helmet we have is Initiative Helmet 1. Standard issue Andromeda Initiative hard suits are designed for exploration as much as combat, combining jump jets, high-grade external and internal sensors, and a variety of atmospheric filters with the usual kinetic barrier, generators, and ceramic armor plating. Personnel equipped in these suits can enter and leave alien biomes without fear of contamination or hostile wildlife. Okay, so this is just a general about the armor itself. It's not telling us specifically helmet. See, same. So these are common arms. Yeah, these are just the different components of that. Plus 2% encounter XP increase for the chest. That's interesting. You get added. So there wasn't anything for this, was it? No. Just checking. No. Okay, and then the legs. Legs. You can see them. Okay. Fusion mods. We don't have that yet. Fusion mods are barely understood bits of remnant tech which can be integrated into Rider's combat armor. While they provide dramatic benefits, this often comes at a cost. Like Magitek kind of thing from Final Fantasy? So we got cryo ammo, we know what that works, but this is different because it lasts for the next 3 clips and then you run out, you need more. Which is different. Never had that happen before. Usually just apply it and it's there until you switch a weapon. Disruptor ammo and shield capacitors. Okay, these are checked. Meaning these are equipped or something. The boost lasts until shields are broken. Restores current shielding to the new maximum. Okay, then research. Oh. Armor blueprints. Oh, God. We have... What? We have all this? 11. We have this stuff? Did we find this on the planet? Or we... Hostile wildlife. This is blueprints for what we currently have on. I guess this comes in handy for making our own armor, weapons, mods, stuff like that. Maverick Skirmisher Arms. There's nothing elegant about this patchwork hard suit. It mixes various materials and technology from the Helios cluster, and its microframe computer runs a jumble of barely linked programs. Despite this, or because of it, the armor is highly effective in combat, with targeting and thermal distribution systems second to none. So it's got +3 weapon headshot and a weak point bonus, and +3% weapon spare ammo. Ditto for this. And +5% weapon damage. Ditto here. Well, we can't drag this, but at least I can scroll with the mouse wheel. Rare blueprint. I was here, right? I was on chest and then helmet. Legs. Pathfinder arms. Uncommon blueprint. Pathfinder hard suits are heavily modified from the initiative suit baseline, foregoing certain scientific instruments in favor of added combat capability. The role of a Pathfinder includes threat neutralization and improved stabilizers and targeting controls help ensure they can protect his or her team. +2 damage resistance and +5% weapon accuracy. So, Pathfinder arms. Wait, find the end. Bloop. Helmet. And the legs. There you go. Alright. And then resources. Minerals. I read this stuff when I picked it up. Platinum we have. Vanadium. I don't remember finding this. This rare metal can be used to produce various construction alloys. Can be detected via orbital scan and mined with the Nomad. It can also be purchased from certain merchants. Alright. And tech materials. Omnigel canister. Okay. Is it? That's common. Alright. Okay, so my statistics, narrative stats. We've already made 12 professional choices. All right, so I'm not very casual. I'm a bit more logical than emotional. So I'm much more professional than casual. Hey, Pathfinder, gotta be professional. Oh, squad skills. Okay, so here's Cora. She's got charge. 4 points. Can I... Can I level something up? No. Oh, I can take rank 2 and charge for her. She has 2 points. Okay, I see that there. It's gonna take me a while to get used to where everything's located on the screen. So we'll go to confirm. And Liam. Oh, his bio. Oh, your bios. Crisis Specialist Level 3. Liam takes solid training and overclocked gear and throws it all against the wall. In the do-whatever-works spirit of his time and crisis response, he gets in and gets attention with big attacks and bigger effects to keep the heat off his team and his targets on their heels. Yes, but what is he like as a person? Havoc Strike. Leaps forward and stabs down at enemies with his Omni-Blades, discharging their power to stun all nearby enemies and prime them for combo detonations. So if you see him do that, then I guess you go in with your power, whatever would combine with this. Can't move him. So we've seen this in the trailer where they jump up and boom down with the Omni-Blade. Pretty cool. There's his frag grenade. I saw him use that in combat. No, I don't... No. I can't... Oh, wait. Okay. Got it. I could have taken this with Cora. I was looking at the second one. I don't know why. So we've learned... Funny, that one doesn't say learn. Confirm. Reject. So what does Cora say? Her, bio. Biotic Commando Level 3. Combining Systems Alliance officer training with years of experience as an Asari Commando. She's not Asari. She was an Asari Commando. Cora is a formidable presence on the battlefield. Powerful biotics send her charging forward to rip through enemy lines, while Cora's tactical knowledge keeps the team organized and their shields replenished. Well, that's got to be story there. How did she trained with the Asari to be one of their commandos? Never heard of that happening before. So, right, I can take this Nova. Got it. Okay, so as for myself, what do I want? I can take maybe some of these. I got concussive shot, omni grenade. Throws a grenade that causes massive area damage after a 2 second fuse. Hold button shortens the grenade's fuse timer before throwing. The grenade will explode if held too long. I'll probably end up killing myself that way. Activation requires 1 power cell from Omnigrade's limited power cell supply. Okay, so we're gonna have to find a power cell each time. Barricade is a shield. Concussive shot, we know what that is. Turbocharge. Vents weapon, okay, trip mine. Flak cannon. Fires Krogan-designed shells that burst into shrapnel upon impact. Shrapnel damage is reduced against armored enemies. Again, power cell. Okay, so this is like... Okay, this is like your weapon specialization. And you can keep leveling these up, I'm sure, to get increased percentage. Yeah, weapon specialization. Combat fitness. First, we need to invest in combat. And combat tools. I think I want this concussive shot. Fires a target seeking high impact round that knocks down armored, unshielded, normal size enemies and detonates combo. So, oh, I can't I need 9 skill points invested in combat, which is... Where? Why does it say Cora Harper here? It said Cora Harper. That is not me. So these grayed out ones we can't do. Okay, I think what we need to do then is put these points into a specialization, combat, or like combat fitness, combat passive, combat tools. So how about assault rifles? ...2% assault rifle stability. Minus 25% assault rifle weight. Well, that's for the next one. Okay, so pretty good. Pretty good. So I want to unlock concussive shot. Hopefully it's as good as the in the previous games. Just a quick way of taking down someone who's like, you know, damaged already. Boom. Dead. So for someone who didn't want to like take a lot of points, but I don't know, there's not a lot of stuff that... Oh, I would have gone in biotics. Well, that's a whole separate. Alright, never mind. I'll take that next time. I have 0 points. Next time I'm definitely going to take some biotics. I just want to get enough to get like concussive shot and then go from there. Like maybe a few ranks in it, and then I'm just gonna go pull, throw. Nova would be good. I assume these work at the same as, you know, the previous games. Shockwave hopefully is good. Backlash is new. Generates a frontal biotic Aegis barrier that reflects most projectiles and reduces the damage of other enemy attacks. Cool. Reflects. Oh, this is the one that like throws your stuff back at the enemy. I like that. I saw that in one of the you know, combat type trailers. A well-timed initial activation interrupts melee attacks too. That'd be good. Singularity, freaking awesome. Lance devastates a small area with swiftly thrown shaft of energy. Inflicts bonus damage against enemy weak points, such as heads. Barrier. Of course, like shields, offensive biotics. Okay. Plus 2% general damage there. Containment. Oh, could this be like stasis that Liara had? Alright. You know, I would have taken this, but I didn't realize. Yeah, this isn't all the skills. They're separated into biotics and tech. I forgot. I know it was right there, but. And then tech. Oh, overload is considered tech, right? Incinerate. Assault turret. We could, like, build our little assault turret. That's cool. Cryo beam. A continuous stream of super cool particles that freezes targets, priming them for combo detonations. Freezing disables unarmored weapons and weakens enemy armor, but has no effect on shielded foes. Energy drain. I can read all these. I mean, some of this we know. I think Tally had energy drain. Tactical cloak. Oh, invisible. At the cost of shield and health regeneration. Now, I'm sure there's a chance for them to, you know, not see you, but, like, know you're there. Sense you, anyway. For, you know, smell, sound, stuff. Flamethrower. This looks awesome in the game demos, trailers that I've seen. Short-range jet of flame that causes bonus damage to armor and ongoing burn damage. Unshielded enemies held in the jet catch fire, priming them for combos. Unknown. Investigate remnant technology to unlock this skill. Ooh, like that. Invasion. infects opponents with an invasive VI-controlled machine swarm that weakens defenses and spreads itself to nearby enemies. That probably looks really cool. Alright, I'm looking forward to checking some of this stuff out. Team support. Defenses and support for the whole squad through kinetic barrier, generator, and hard suit enhancements. Offensive techs. Tech. Maximizes offensive capabilities through Omnitool software and hardware. Auxiliary systems. Improves the effectiveness of tech powers and constructs in a variety of ways thanks to sub-customized Omnitool and hard suit subsystems. Okay. That's cool. There's a lot of cool stuff in there. I hope I get, you know, a bunch of levels soon so I can, like, check this stuff out. Lots of inventory and skills. And here's profiles. Cool. Alright. Okay. Now, I hope you guys don't hate this episode too much. I am going to, you know, do some more stuff. It's going to be an extra long episode, because all I really did was talk to Sam and look at skills and weapons and profiles and stuff.
Welcome back, Sarah.
Literally, that's it. Okay, we'll talk to him some more, and we'll go somewhere else in the ship and see what other trouble we can get into. Welcome back. Yeah, about my implant.
What more can you tell me about my implant?
The implant itself provides me with direct access to your senses. I can see, hear, and experience the same stimuli you do while in the field. This raw data enables me to provide real-time feedback and analysis of the situation.
Then Dad added the secret sauce.
You removed the restrictions on my access to Pathfinder physiology.
Just be careful.
Uh-huh. Just promise you won't fry my brain or anything?
Trust is an important concept in any relationship. Alec taught me that. I will not fry your brain. It would end badly for both of us.
Me more than you.
It looks like a heart. Like a diagram of a heart, almost. I like that when she was like, uh-huh. Yeah, she might be growing on me a little bit. What's your location?
I take it you're based here in Samnode?
Correct. This is where my core processing unit resides. However, using quantum entanglement communication, I remain in constant touch with you and the Pathfinder mission team, even over great distances.
And what's your abilities?
What are your capabilities?
Each arc houses a SAM, Simulated Adaptive Matrix.
That's what it means.
Each is an artificial intelligence designed by Alec Ryder to support Pathfinders and their teams.
But AI is illegal in the Milky Way. How did my dad get around that?
Exceptions were made. The initiative deemed his research vital to the mission. Our design was conducted in secret.
Hmm. Are there any other SAMs?
So there are other SAMs out there?
Correct. However, your father continued to modify my own routines until the Hyperion's departure. I am the most advanced SAM in the initiative.
Well, I bet you're pretty proud of yourself. So do we have some sort of symbiotic relationship then you were mentioning?
What did he mean by a symbiotic relationship?
Symbiosis is a mutually beneficial relationship between two life forms. A flower provides nectar to a bee, who in turn provides pollen for the flower. The bee gains nourishment, and the flower can propagate. In similar fashion, my own evolution was shaped by your father's experiences, and will now expand with yours.
It's a little different.
In return, I provide you with capabilities and analysis beyond normal human faculties. We each benefit.
It's a little different, I'm afraid. The bee gets to fly away and do its own thing, whereas you're still in my head forever. Do you have any idea how my brother's doing?
Do you know anything more about Scott's condition?
I monitor Dr. Carlisle's reports. He is providing Scott with the very best care possible. I'm afraid there is nothing more to be done at this time.
Huh. Well, in that case, goodbye.
That's all for now.
Of course.
But of course. Alright. Let's see what else there is to do around here. I was supposed to go back in there. Find a way to remove Sam's memory blocks. Your father locked portions of Sam's memory array, and Sam is unable to recall certain information. You must explore in order to find the numerous memory triggers scattered throughout the world. The world. Alright. Let's go in there again. Too bad I didn't go to Sam first, right? So, I've looked at this stuff. Oh, memory trigger. Okay, I got it. There's a memory trigger over there. What do you excerpt? Memory trigger. Picking up. What are we picking up? A globe of light. Oh, I didn't mean to hit coffee machine.
The coffee machine Mom got for Dad. He was so busy designing you. Sam? What was that?
An eidetic trigger. Related to your father, and the portions of my memory array he locked.
What triggered it?
Alec tied it to your progression as Pathfinder, not to a location. Puzzling as it may be, my programming is clear. Locating more of these triggers will unlock the memories. One of your father's memories is now accessible. Return to SAM node on the Hyperion to investigate further.
Back and forth, back and forth. Well, at least it's close. Ah! The door should open so that I can't possibly run fast enough to run into them. I must complain to the engineer.
Ryder, the blocks your father placed on my array are opening. I can now recall specific memories which Alec wanted you to see.
Okay.
Wait, I can actually see his memories?
Yes, you will experience them via your implant.
Sweet.
Okay, something new every day.
Play the tape.
Let's see it.
This memory is from the time when your father was posted on the Citadel.
Alec, your recommendations will never fly. Artificial intelligence?
It's our best option.
If the Council gets wind of this, it'll set humanity standing back decades. You're overreaching.
This memory is echoing.
Ambassador Goyle, I'm the military attaché on the Citadel. My mandate is clear. Find an edge for Earth.
And AI is your answer?
We need to catch up. The Asari, the Salarians, they're centuries ahead of us.
But it's illegal.
Hello?
Their rules, not ours. Why deny Earth an advantage?
Define this advantage.
It will set us free. We're prisoners of our own five senses. There's a reality greater than ours that we can't perceive. But an AI can.
So she's Goyle. Is he
Crab? By augmenting her own abilities and adding a few new ones.
Well, none of that stopped those Geth from revolting.
Because they were separate from their creators. But AIs and humans interface directly, experiencing the world together, benefits both.
Meh. Green ending.
There's no creator to revolt against.
Green ending.
I'm sorry, Alec.
Synthesis.
You can't take the risk. I appreciate your work, but your request will be denied.
Damn. But we want synthesis. No, wait, do we?
Alec?
Oh!
Ellen, what did the doctor say?
He told me to appreciate the time I have left. There's no cure, Alec. It's terminal.
What?
Not on my watch.
He had a terminal something?
Wow, hearing Mom again. I never knew that's how Dad found out.
Oh, his...
Alec was a stubborn man.
Okay, her mother. Well, Mom's life was at stake.
I would hope so. Mom's life was worth fighting for.
It would seem his obstinance extended to me as well.
Nobody wanted to listen. The idea of you scared people too much. After this, Dad moved us back to Earth to care for Mom. Wonder why he wanted me to see this.
Perhaps it was the beginning.
Of what?
Unknown. Private audio logs are now available in your father's quarters. I detect additional memories, but they are currently locked. They may yet hold answers.
Okay, I'll keep working on it. That's all for now.
Of course.
Cool. I kind of like this, you know. Added story. I like it. We get to unlock more or learn more about our father and Got that, I always forget his name, the guy who played the Kurgan. I remember his name when I'm not playing the game, so if you guys put in a comment, I'll be like, I know. It's just on the tip of my tongue. So we got a coffee machine, we got an archive system, we got audio excerpt. Well, these are Liara's audio excerpts. Are they not? Maybe if I go here to the archive system. So it gives him more lines, and it gets we learn more about our father as we go, which unlocks more story and narrative exposition, what have you, which is neat. I like that. I'm a big sucker for story. It's really... that's what keeps me interested in the game. And the characters, mostly.
Your father's personal logs.
Okay, Ellen's disease. Okay, these are the logs. These are the things that get unlocked. Alright, so that was...
that log is not currently accessible. Unlocking my memory array may enable it.
That was encrypted log number one. Anything here? Where those are. Okay, Ellen's disease.
Amazing how life can change in an instant. Suddenly my career doesn't matter. This incredible woman I've been married to all these years. She's facing the end. All I think about are the times I wasn't there for her. Well, that's going to change. It occurs to me that Sam might be more than I ever imagined.
Hmm. Okay. Now what? Still weird how I picked up the Normandy and nothing happened. Like, it's not in my inventory or anything. I guess it's this extra thing. Can we unlock any more? Is that it for now?
Welcome back, Sarah.
That's all for now.
Of course.
Okay, so at some point, maybe around the ship, we'll find more of these memories. Are you planning on attacking those seats, sir? See, now we're pretty much running fine. It's only when I load the game up that it's like that. Did I talk to her? Zara?
Zara Kellis?
Yes?
I have evidence you've been sabotaging the Nexus.
Right, she's that one.
What? No, I'd never... I've been looking into this myself. I have the scans to prove it. Here, I'll transfer the scans I took to your Omnitool.
Funny. Raj was investigating the same thing, and it led us to you.
My scans point at Raj as the one. So unless someone was setting us both up, I just don't understand.
The data Miss Kellis has accumulated is strangely similar to Mr. Patel's. A third party seems likely.
A decoy tactic?
The real saboteur could be setting you both up.
Because we both figured out something was going on?
Clever.
That
clever.
Would make sense.
So clever.
It's better than thinking Raj could have done this. But it means all the data I have is useless. Wish I had access to the security cams. I bet we could find something there.
You stay put, so whoever did this doesn't realize we're onto them. I'll check out the security cams. Raj, you there?
Yes. How did it go? Is it really her?
Guess not.
Wasn't her. She had proof pointing at you. I figure someone's been messing with you both. Just keep a low profile and don't talk to anyone. I'm on it.
On it. We talked to Lanny already, right?
Pathfinder?
Yeah, talk to you later.
Have to go now. See you later.
Take care.
So... whatever's in there, I can't get in there. Atrium. Not sure if I ran up here. So we need to get Captain Dunn. We need to get access to security logs.
Ryder, you're not on the bridge, Captain?
We powered it down. Can't afford to waste energy.
Hmm.
Though Cryo Bay and Sam Node are exempt. And I told them to keep their hands off Alex's quarters. You have access now.
Thanks.
Hey, sorry about your father.
Why is it like
this? He was really good at what he did. Just not so good at working with people.
Why is she here?
He was right about going planetside, though.
I mean, this is really what I want to see when I with the cutscene involving two people, with her over here with half her head, well, okay, a fifth of her head cut off, and my shoulder. I'll miss him.
I wish he were still here. There's so much he could have taught me.
You'll do fine. You're off to a good start. If there's anything else I can help with, let me know.
Your role... Well, I guess, do you do anything besides captain the ship?
Now that the Hyperion is docked, what will you do?
Normally, I'd supervise thawing out the colonists, but that's been put on hold. I hear you're the one helping resolve the issue. Good luck with that.
Thanks. What are your expectations?
If someone had told you that you'd be in the Andromeda cluster even 5 years ago...
Are you kidding me? I'd have laughed them out of the quadrant. Although, the way things are now isn't exactly what I was hoping for, either. We all knew there was a possibility on arrival of less than ideal circumstances.
Hmm.
When you sign up, you hope for the best, and plan for the worst.
How did you join the initiative?
Why did you join the initiative? We're a long way from home.
How could I not? I love my job. Coming here, all this, it was just a logical extension of what I already do. Sailing through new stars, discovering new worlds. What self-respecting explorer could pass that up?
That's it for now. I'm done looking at the control panel, thanks.
Thanks for the talk.
All right. I have requests to submit, administrators to harass, and people to wake up. I'd better get to it. Good luck out there.
You just said that was on hold. Anything else to say?
Ryder, this new station leadership I'm hearing about finally let you out of their sight?
Looks like.
Took them long enough.
Okay.
Thanks for the talk.
Sure thing.
Okay, so stay tuned for next episode when we accomplish something. We gotta find security cameras. So I guess it's gonna be down that way. I guess this. Whatever that is. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time for a shorter episode. And endure. In enduring? Good God. Grow strong.